coming up on MCTV this week. Finals are right around the corner, and with that, stress. And as the semester comes to a close, students got to show off their best work. This week starts now. Hello and welcome to MCTV This Week. For Bronwyn File, I'm Cameron Lyne. Every year, Scholars Day gives the chance for students to present their research to the school, and in the case of one group, those research studies have very real implications for Monmouth College.
Slutwalk raised awareness, if not a few eyebrows, marching around campus to protest rape culture. Rape culture is a term for when the normal attitudes prevalent in a culture excuse, tolerate, and condone sexual assault. Last Wednesday at Scholars Day, the Women's Justice and Equality class revealed the data from their sexual attitude survey. The survey was given to 212 Monmouth College students after the Slutwalk. The data showed trends that troubled but did not necessarily surprise those involved in the research.
We had how often does sexually harassing language occur on campus, daily, 48.1%. And then, have you ever made fun of a woman or called her a slut because of her sexual behavior? 61% said yes.
What the capstone class found interesting is that despite a large number of respondents that said they'd experienced sexual harassment or assault, 67% said they didn't know sexual assault was a problem on Monmouth's campus.
That kind of says to us that students are not being educated on what sexual assault even is. And I think that's something that we hope the Slutwalk can promote, is increasing education and awareness about what sexual assault is so that they know how to report it.
The organizers are hoping that Slutwalk will become an annual event that will continue to raise awareness in the years to come.
With finals starting in 2 days, students have a lot of work to do. Tory Philbin has some information on some things that might help you prepare.
As finals are approaching, many students get stressed around this time of year.
I feel like professors are kind of loading the work on at the end of the semester here, but some papers and finals for a couple classes, so it's kind of piled up.
But. You can't even think about studying for finals yet because you have so much to finish up, but you get used to it, being a college student.
Sometimes it's hard, especially in big groups where people keep coming up with problems and intergroup problems, but this is probably the worst it's been. I don't know if that's the 4-4 or if it's because I'm a senior and don't care anymore.
Stress is considered to be a typical part of everyday life. It is usually considered to be a bad thing. However, stress can be used in a positive manner. It motivates behavior change and goal setting. Although having a certain amount of stress is necessary, it is not a good thing to have too much stress.
We can't keep demanding of ourselves to be able to handle more and more. We need to get some rest. So self-care is extremely important, getting rest, eating well. Then if we can methodically work our way through it a little bit at a time, kind of an inchworm thing, spread it out with assignments. We want to spread things out and go at it one at a time.
Some of the major signs of stress include headaches, digestive problems, inability to retain information, and excessive anger. Many people deal with stress by picking up good and bad habits, but doing so creates more problems.
So if a person has a tendency to avoid circumstances, they're probably going to avoid. For people who withdraw, they're going to withdraw, pull the covers over their head, and not want to deal with things. For people who fight or get agitated, they're probably going to try to push away or blame others for their stress. That's when the tendency for maladaptive, addictive, compulsive behaviors occur. So people who are inclined to try to get out of their stress by avoidance.
There are several ways to rejuvenate the body, such as meditating, exercising, talking to a friend, and engaging in art and music.
Leave time for fun. Make sure that you are participating in things that are going on so you don't get kind of obsessive and worrisome.
For MCTV, I'm Tory Philbin.
If you ever need to talk to someone about dealing with stress, you can visit Cindy Beatles in the basement of Polling Hall.
April is National Poetry Month, and MC took a moment to find its muse. Last Thursday, professors and students read a variety of poems written by famous poets, along with reading some of their original work. Some poets were recited in Spanish, German, and Scottish.
Well, April is National Poetry Month, so this is sort of our local reminder that poems exist and people read them. And we've done this a number of times in the past, not every year, but almost every year, going back over a decade. So that's one of the reasons. Plus, I think it's kind of fun to find out what kind of poems your colleagues like and read. And it just tells you something about the people you associate with every day that you otherwise wouldn't notice.
McEwen hopes to hold the event again next April.
Taking a look at some events on campus this week. Tomorrow night at 5, the Sassy Lassies will perform their end-of-the-year concert in the Dahl Chapel. Finals start on Friday, and graduation is Sunday the 12th at noon on the Wallace Hall lawn.
Up next in sports, MC Softball ushers out a pair of seniors on Senior Day with a doubleheader against Washington University. We've got the highlights next. Saturday afternoon marked Senior Day for MC Softball, and Coach Goddard's squad looked to send off a pair of seniors with a pair of non-conference victories. Senior outfielders Courtney Bennett and Samantha Sons were honored before the contest in front of a capacity crowd. Bottom one, Emily Watkins singles to center field, driving home Summer Foster, and it's quickly 1-0 Monmouth College. But back come the Bears in the second. Ashley Jansen scores Adrienne White on this sacrifice fly, capping a 3-run inning, Wash U back on top 3-1. Despite combining for 8 more hits, neither team could find the scoreboard in the final 5 innings. The Scots would strand 3 down the stretch, coming up short in this one, 3-1, your final score.
It's mixed emotions. I really am going to miss them next year, their leadership, their playing, but it's also time for them to move on to another chapter of their life and become productive citizens.
Monmouth's offensive woes continued in game two. Top four already down 1-0. Wash U torches the Scots bullpen for 7 earned runs in relief of starter Taylor Smith. The Bears scored twice more in the fifth, putting the game away in only 5 innings of work. The Bears would end Monmouth's inspired season in shutout fashion, 10-0, your final score.
Most of the game we played well. The rest, that one inning, which has been our operating procedure here lately, is to have a bad inning and cost us a game.
In first place just 2 short weeks ago, MC Softball dropped 9 of their final 10 games, falling 1 game shy of the Midwest Conference Tournament. Coach Goddard's squad ends their inspired campaign with a disappointing record of 15-19. After taking both ends of a doubleheader from the Grinnell Pioneers last Thursday, MC Baseball would need some more magic on Saturday against Grinnell to keep their playoff hopes alive. Junior Brick Wedekind on the mound, looking for his first win of the season. Bottom four, Scots down 1-0. Andrew Baudino singles to left field, then takes second base on a wild cutoff attempt. Matt Glenn would score to tie the game at 1 apiece. To the fifth inning we go, up 2-1 and looking for more. Philip Zarconi goes deep to left. His 3-run shot made it 5-1 visitors. Trailing 7-1 in the ninth inning, Glenn scores on a fielder's choice, but MC drops game one 7-2.
It didn't go our way, obviously, but been struggling with that all year, so just got to battle through it, keep keep playing hard. Just pride. That's what we're playing for right now is pride. I think we know we're out of it, but we still can play some games here.
With their playoff hopes dashed, MC Baseball dropped game two as well, 8-5. They do have two more doubleheaders coming up in conference play. Though they're mathematically eliminated from the conference tournament, they do face Cornell for a pair of doubleheaders, the first of which will occur this Saturday at Mount Vernon, Iowa, first pitch scheduled for noon. That'll wrap things up for sports this week, and that'll mark the end of my tenure here on MCTV. David Beidle will take over next season as anchor, and we wish him the best of luck. Here are your scores for this week.
Hey, wait a minute. Where do you think you're going? Yeah, that's right. Over here, tiger. Where do you think you're going without washing your hands? No one likes a dirty boy. Come on and turn me on. You know you want to. That toilet you just used, it carries 2 million bacteria per inch. Yuck. Ooh, yeah, that's it. Wash those hands. Ooh, soap. Yeah, perfect. Use soap. Ooh, scrub them good. Come back and see me anytime.
Welcome back. Last week, Monmouth College students got the chance to showcase their hard work at the MCTV Film Festival. The 9th annual MCTV Film Festival is held on Scholars Day to display PSAs, news stories, and short films created by Monmouth College students from all different backgrounds and majors. The festival gave students an opportunity to see the finished products on the big screen.
I hope students take away a desire to make more. You know, we have a lot of good stuff this year. We had a lot of great shows and movies and stuff like that, and hopefully next year we can have even better stuff and even more stuff. You know, we saw a lot of variety, but we're always looking for new people who are inspired to do it.
Gavin Bogan won the Best of Show Award for his PSA on littering, and Kyle McEwen won the Butts Award for Outstanding Senior. Also, the audience got to vote for the People's Choice Award, which was won by Tory Philbin.
It just feels good to win something, and I want to be like a news anchor in the future too, and like report good stories beforehand, so it's really good to get a good start, and winning that award is like a good stepping stone too for my career.
You can find all the films that were featured at the festival by going to monmouthcollege.edu/MCTV.
That's it for MCTV this week. I'm Kyle McEwen.
And I'm Bronwyn File. Have a great summer, and we'll see you next year.
And I'm Cameron Lyne. From all of us to all of you, the loyal viewer, we thank you for a fantastic year. And remember, you can always find us on the web by going to monmouthcollege.edu/MCTV. Thank you for watching. We'll see you next year.
Coming up on MCTV this week. Monmouth students give a helping hand to the community and learn proper... Sorry. Can we do it again?
Welcome back. Last Monday, Mexican folklore dance instructor Celia Campos brought some liveliness to campus.
There's your scores for this week. Dang it. Whenever. Going up. The women playing a conference tournament on Saturday in Iowa. All right.
Anytime. Okay. Last week, students got the chance to learn proper and... I'm not going to fuck this up. I'm not. The next ASAP event will be on March 22nd when...
March 22nd.
ASAP. I didn't say...
This past weekend... Fuck. This is out of here. This is done.
ASAP event will be on March 22nd. The next ASAP event will be on March 22nd when comedian Chad Daniels will be performing in the Doll Chapel.
Oh. I wasn't ready.
You did so good.
Oh, boy. Oh, no.
I forgot we were doing that. My bad.
There you go.
What do you say? It's hot in here.
I feel like I'm sweating.
Is it hot in here? Or is it just me?
Oh, no.
What happened?
Yeah.
I bet that means, I don't know what that is, but I bet we have to do it again.
I bet you guessed right.
The woman. It's all about them women, let me tell you.
Thursday night at 9 p.m. in the Underground with a coffee house perform. Sorry.
Welcome back. Last night, Monmouth College students and staff met and gathered in the... Thanks. Okay.
Ready? The women playing a conference tournament on Saturday in Iowa. I can't do this anymore. All right. Here we go. We're doing it. Maybe. It's hot in here.
Welcome back. Last night, Monmouth College student and faculty gathered for a night of humor and poetry.
The women playing a conference sermon on Saturday, and I... I almost had it. All right. That might be a good idea. I can't watch myself.
Christmas art will be on display through March 28th in Monmouth's Everett Gallery on the upper stairs level of... Is upper... That's not right, is it?
Here, Martell Hunter would also get into the action with an old-fashioned three-point play at the end of the first quarter. Scott's... Can we do restart that? It's not the Scots, it's the Titans, God damn it.
That's not right, is it?
The women play in a conference tournament on Saturday in Iowa.
In the Hughes Library, Everett Gallery in the Hughes Library. Although, I have trouble with the Hughes Library, too.
The women... Shut up. I know I am. Just bloop me up, I guess. Scotty.
That's MCTV This Week. I'm Kyle McEwen.
And I'm Tory Philbin. Be sure to tune in next Wednesday for a new edition of MCTV.
And I'm Cameron Lyne, reminding you, you... Oh, fuck.
This weekend, St. Norbert. This weekend, they play St. Norbert in the conference. No, get out of here. No. You're the... This is weird, Kyle.
That's more aesthetically pleasing, doing it this way. I don't know which way is better.
The woman playing a conference. I had it, Chris. I had it that time, and you just ruined it. It messed me up. I would have had it.
It's relaxing.
Oh.
It's
all right. I about said it too, and he would have been back. All right. This is going to be it, just saying.
I don't know what that is, but I bet we have to do it again.
Nope. What did he say? Oh yeah, it's sweaty, nice and sweaty. This weekend, the volleyball team goes to Iowa to play in the conference tournament. There's your sports for this week. Freaking dang it!
Christmas art will be on display through March 28th in the Hughes Library's Everett Gallery on the upper stairs. Yeah.
Remind me what I say there.
Here's a look at sports. Here are your scores for this week.
That's a look at sports. Here are your scores for this week. I know. All right. I got it. This weekend, the volleyball team goes to Iowa to play in the conference championship. That's a look at sports. Here's your scores for this week.
This is out of here. This is done.
Here I am waiting. I'll have to leave soon. Why am I holding on? We knew this day would come. We knew it all along. How did it come so fast? This is our last night, but it's late, and I'm trying not to sleep, 'cause I know.
Watch a bunch of bloopers and I make a blooper. It's like a direct thing.